Maya is a 3D content creation tool used to generate virtual characters, environments, animations, and effects. It allows you to work with these assets in real time and later render them at a high fidelity when you're ready to present them. In this movie, we'll focus on the interface and scene navigation. The Maya interface is divided into four major regions. The upper region contains the menus, status line, and shelves. These tools are mostly used for creating and editing objects in your scene. The lower region contains the time slider and command line. These tools are dedicated to animation and scripting. The side regions contain the toolbox, quick layout buttons, channel box, and layer editor. These tools allow you to manipulate objects in your workspace or the layout of the workspace itself. Finally, the center region houses your workspace. This is where you can view and interact with your scene. Let's start by looking at the top region of the interface. You can access many of Maya's functions from the menus along the top of the application. Some of the most commonly used menus, such as those to create objects, are always located here. The rest of the list changes depending on which menu set is currently active via the menu set drop-down list. Menu sets are organized by common workflows, such as animation, modeling, dynamic simulation, and rendering. If you ever have trouble finding a certain menu, the first thing to check is that you're in the right menu set. If you want to keep a menu visible at all times, you can tear it off by clicking the dotted line. You are now free to drag it around the interface. Below the menus is the status line. The status line shows you the current state of many of the toggleable interaction modes, such as object versus component interaction, snapping, and construction history. For more information on the status line, see our tutorial on manipulating objects. Many of the commands in the menus can also be found in the Maya shelves. Maya's default shelves house commonly used functions, and like menu sets, they are organized by related workflows. You can also create your own custom shelves. For more information on shelves, see our tutorial about working with shelves. The bottom portion of Maya's interface is dedicated to animation and scripting. The time slider allows you to quickly navigate your animation frames by clicking and dragging over it, also known as scrubbing. You can also use the playback controls on the right to play through your animation or step through keyframes. By default, Maya displays 24 animation frames. You can drag the range slider control or use the input boxes to add more time to your animation or display a subset of it. If your scene contains animation data stored in animation layers or character sets, you can select them from their respective drop-down lists. Refer to our animation playlist in the Maya Learning channel for more in-depth animation tutorials. The command line underneath allows you to run commands directly via MEL or Python script. Scripting can be used to automate repetitive tasks. For example, you could write a script that renames and recolors 1,000 objects with the click of a single button. You can also use scripts to achieve custom behavior that is otherwise not possible. For example, you can script specific behaviors to trigger only when conditions in your scene are just right. Refer to our scripting playlist in the Maya Learning channel for more in-depth scripting tutorials. On the left side, we can see the toolbox, which is used to select and interact with objects in your scene. When you select an object, the channel box on the right lists its transform values, such as its position and rotation. The layer editor below shows us a list of layers in our scene. Adding objects to layers helps divide and manage a crowded scene. For more information on the toolbox, channel box, and layer editor, see our tutorial on manipulating objects. For now, let's turn our attention to the workspace. The Maya workspace is the area of the interface where we can interact with our scene. The workspace can be viewed in a number of different modes, accessible via the icons in the panel toolbar or through the 4-7 hotkeys. Wireframe shows only the geometry lines of objects in your scene. Smooth Shade All shows you the base materials, essentially their color. Maya also offers a wireframe unshaded mode that combines these two modes together. Textured shows you the 2D textures associated with each material. And Use All Lights shows the effects of any lights. If you have problems with lighting or textures not showing up in your scene, make sure you are in the right mode. You can control the camera in the scene by holding Alt and dragging any of the mouse buttons. Alt with left mouse button rotates the camera around a focal point, also known as tumbling. Alt with middle mouse button slides the camera on its current axis, also known as tracking. And Alt with right mouse button moves the camera into or away from the scene, also known as dollying. You can also auto-frame your scene using the F key. Pressing it without any object selected frames your entire scene. While pressing it with an object selected frames that specific object. Right now we're viewing our scene in default quality. You can switch to high quality to see more advanced shading effects, such as normal maps, not available in default quality mode. You can also choose Viewport 2.0, which acts as an interactive rendering preview by showing you an image much closer to that of the final rendered look. Depending on your system configuration, these render quality settings can impact the interactive performance of your scene. You can toggle between them to find the one that best suits your needs. Maya's default vantage point is through the perspective camera. To view the scene through additional cameras, click the 4-View Quick Layout button. By default, each scene you create in Maya also has a top, side, and front camera. These are known as orthographic views because they view the scene in 2D instead of 3D. Notice that unlike the perspective view, you cannot tumble the camera in any of these orthographic views. You can expand any of these views to the workspace by putting your cursor in the appropriate quadrant and pressing spacebar. You can quickly return to the 4-view layout by tapping spacebar again. There are various other quick layouts designed to give you a variety of information about your scene. The usefulness of each one will depend on whether you're modeling, animating, rendering, and so forth. If you're new to 3D, you will probably find the 4-view and perspective view options the most useful for now. You should now have a basic understanding of the Maya interface and how to navigate around your scene. You can find more information and in-depth tutorials on all aspects of Maya via the Maya Learning Channel. In the Maya documentation included with the software, or online at the Autodesk website.